What do you think about, you know...
He's practiced it so hard that gives him the confidence to do it in the... T20 is about... Rahul Dravid, Sachin have been very, very...
You were basically...
You know, it's a different skill. What does it... I think it's a very, very interesting debate. I think...
Challenger final, when you walked out to walked out with Sachin Tendulkar, so how was that feeling? And you know, how was that moment with you?
Actually, it was a dream come true, definitely, no doubt about it. I think there were 10,000 people on the ground, and I think 9,999 were cheering for him walking out. But anyway, I think the greatest thing was, you know, he made things very, very simple. You know, he has such an aura. I think one person you see, you get goosebumps. You know, he has that kind of, I think, I've met a lot of great players, I've played with a lot of great players, but he has an aura which nobody else has, you know, and he made things very, very simple. It was like walking into bat with your friend or something. So he made life very, very simple. It was definitely an unforgettable moment, because I think that's the only time I played with him for the same time. I played a lot against him, obviously Rally Trophy games and, you know, and IPLs and everything. So there's the only time I played with him the entire tournament, and that game I got to play. So I think it was a dream come true. And like I said, you know, he made things very, very... You didn't feel like you're batting with the legend of the game or the greatest to play. It just felt like he made me feel like I'm just batting with somebody else. So I think it's something I'll cherish for a long, long time.
And your 87, you know, was the, you know, icing on the cake, right? So how was he as a, you know, how was he as a person off the field? I mean we read a lot of things about him, you know, preparing for the game, right? So you would have seen him in close quarters, right? So how was he different to others while preparing for the game?
One thing was sure was he was just coming back from his tennis elbow injury, so he used the tournament to, you know, get back into, you know, good rhythm. So I was very lucky to share a car ride with him from Mohali Stadium to Chandigarh, with the hotel, which is actually a 45-minute drive. And I think the thing with Sharad was, you know, he still had pain. He told me, like, even to carry a toothpick was so difficult when he started up, but he still had pain. And he knew that certain things he couldn't do, you know, like really go hard at the ball and, you know, really punch the ball. But he was such a great player. He found ways of being successful without doing that, like, you know, allowing the ball to come and work the ball, and, you know. So I think that's a hallmark of a champion. When he had a problem with his tennis elbow, he found a way to be successful by, you know, using other means, which not many people can do. So that's something he spoke about, and I was just flabbergasted by that, because sometimes we tend to complain a lot that this is not okay, that's not okay. But I think this champion, you know, his entire front elbow was not okay when he was playing a shot. Still, he was I think he got a 240 against Bangladesh.
Yeah.
Why he was just, you know, maneuvering the ball beautifully around. So I think that was a great lesson that you're not going to be, you know, 100% okay all the time, but you can still find a way to be very, very successful. So that's, I think, a great learning curve for me, which I try to imbibe to a lot of my kids when I coach now.
Yeah, so coming back to, you know, your family, you had a, you know, you had a father who, he was a, you know, legend in his own right, you know, in Tamil Nadu cricketing circle. So do you, you know, talk cricket at home? Do you, you know, get some advice, or how is that bonding at home with you?
Yeah, I think my father has been wonderful, not only as a father, but the way he's brought me up to play the game. I think father and son relationship, you take it for granted.
Yeah.
So today I sit back and realize that, you know, if I listened to my father, you know, if I taking his advice, you know, I think I'd have been a lot more successful. But anyway, he never put any pressure on me to take the game. It's something I, you know, started playing, and he never said, you have to play this, you have to play that. He always felt that I had the potential to play, and he gave me a free hand to it, which I'm very, very lucky to have a father like that. But like I said, I repeat, you know, I really wish I didn't look at him as a great player. I looked at him as a father. So maybe if I looked at him as a very, very good player who's played first class cricket for 17 years and, you know, played 100 games, if I look at him at that point, if he maybe, you know, grasped a lot more knowledge from him. But I didn't look at him in that way. I looked at him as a father who was just, you know. So I think he's been a fantastic dad. But cricketing wise, I did take a few points from him, but definitely I could have, you know, opened out a lot more to him, spoken to him about a lot more about the game, and I think I would have learned a lot more. But anyways, better late than never. I hope I'm able to imbibe what I've learned from him to a lot of young kids I'm coaching now. Yeah,
so you were a bowler who, you know, you turned into a, you know, batsman, right? So typically what Sunil Narayan does, right? It's very interesting. He started as a bowler. Nobody knew that he was, you know, yeah, he had some batting skills, but nowadays he's doing it very consistently at the top of the order, right? So what do you think, you know, is the success to, you know, score at a great strike rate as well as, you know, be consistent at the top of the order? So any, you know, success mantra that you would
I think it's assessing the conditions, you know. I think Kane Williamson is amazing at that. You know, he assesses the conditions and take the sunrises. He knows that 150 is a winning target in
those conditions.
In those Uppal Stadium conditions, where it's not the best wicket to bat. I think Uppal is one of the biggest grounds. It has an 80
meter, exactly.
So he knows you're not going to get that 200. So I think assessing the conditions is the key, and you know, and adaptability is very, very you know. So I think as a batsman, you go, obviously you work on your skill. To be the best possible player in that format. So you go to Chinnaswamy Stadium and you say, okay, this is a 200 wicket, and you play according to that. You go to Hyderabad and you say, so I think assessing the condition is very, 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 very important, and trying to understand what shots need to be played well, you know, what kind of bowler you need to wait for to be. So I think all that, and that's why coming back to CSK, that's why they are so good, because experience matters so much. You know, Watson knows that, you know, maybe in these conditions I need to take the 10-15 balls extra to get my eye in, but I can always make up if I spend more time in the wicket. So I think that is very, very important, and experience plays a big role in that. So I think very, very important is how you are able to execute your skill under pressure. You know, I think doing it in the nets is very easy, but you come and play the lap shot in the nets, you know, you get it. But doing it against Mitchell Stark, who bowls 150 at a crunch situation, is what shows true strength of character. So more than I think that's the most important thing, how you are able to, you know, handle pressure and how you're able to get your A game during that time.
Yeah, so if you wanted to, you know, play IPL this season, right, so which team you would, you know, wish to have picked, I mean, played for? I know definitely it will be Chennai Super Kings. So, I mean, apart from that, do you have any other, you know, I could have played with, you know, certain cricketers?
Yeah.
You would have felt that?
Obviously, CSK is my first love, because I played and we have such a fantastic leader in Dhoni. But it would have been lovely to play with Virat and AB de Villiers. So, I think RCB would have been a very, very good thing for me. So, I think if you ask me any other team I would like to play for, at present, definitely it would be RCB. Yeah.
So, coming back to this season, so who do you think, you know, is the favourite to, you know, go and get the title at this stage of the tournament?
At this stage, I think, I think it's going to be Sunrisers or Kings 11 or CSK. So, I honestly believe that bowlers win championships, and I think Sunrisers are doing it beautifully. I think batsmen can win you 1, 2 or 3 games, but I think consistent bowling can win you champ. I think Sunrisers has a fantastic bowling unit, and the batsmen are coming to form. Shikhar got coming back to form. Kane Wilson has been a revelation in this tournament. I'm sure the, you know, people like Deepak Hooda, Yusuf Pathan will come into, you know, and they're not being in the best batting conditions as well.
Yeah.
So I think Sunrisers are hot favourites. I think I've worked with Ashwin. I think he's a tremendous leader, you know, and I think he has the knack of, you know, playing the big games well. So I think that's very, very important. So it's going to be I think Sunrisers, Kings 11, and of course CSK. You can never let, I think Dhoni is somebody who plays the big games really well.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's why if they're able to stay fit through the tournament, I think that's why experience matters.
Okay, all right. Thanks a lot for your time, with you. Yeah, it was great to have you on the show.
Lovely. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thanks.